Hi, guys. I'm Erica.
Ryan.
We are the Traveling Gaijin of Okinawa. I know. So, today is very warm. We got a later start. It's Ryan's Monday off. And he had to do some things. We got off a little later. It's a little warm.
Because of me,
it's okay.
We're late.
No, but it's okay. We came down here down to the middle part of the island by Naha. It's Uroso. And we're going to make a couple stops today. First is Hacksaw Ridge. Great spot. We've been here. I don't even know. I've lost track. We bring everybody here that we know. And we've been here a couple times just to revisit because it's just so incredible. And
if you haven't seen the movie,
yeah,
watch Hacksaw Ridge,
and we'll talk about the history a little bit more up there. So Hacksaw Ridge, and then
Kakazu Ridge.
Kakazu Ridge.
I'll get it right someday.
I know, I always get it mixed up. I always call it Kokosai Ridge, and that's not what it is. So I always right,
Kakazu Ridge.
We'll go over there. And then we'll just kind of play it by ear to see if there's anything else we want to go see. But those for sure. Oh, there are castle ruins here too. Uroso castle ruins that we'll go down and see. Oh, and then up here also is Needlepoint Rock. We have a secret way to get over there because they've closed off the path. But we have a secret way. So we'll try to get over there and show you. Okay? All right. Join us on our little adventure. Recording earlier and I did my old spiel and nothing. Anyway, we took pictures and videos and we started walking away, and then we realized we probably should get some history of Uroso Castle. So this is Uroso Castle. It's at the base of Hacksaw Ridge, actually. We're going to be going up there in a minute. Hacksaw Ridge is up above. But Uroso Castle was constructed in the 13th century, and then it was renovated in 1620 by King Shone. And then in this crypt is one king. And then in the crypt over there is another king. It's King Shone, actually, and his family. And so the skeletal remains are still in there. And I don't know if you can see, but on the doors, they are chained and locked up so people can't get in there. Honestly, not that it would matter, because Japanese people, especially Okinawans, are so honest and respectful. I don't think they would ever dare break in. But you never know, us Yankees. Just kidding. Anyway, so this is Uroso Castle. So there's not a ton. These were all rebuilt like in 2005. This is not original, but they're kind of going by the plans that they had, that this is what it probably looked like. So, but the crypts are original. And then we'll head up on top to go to Hacksaw Ridge.
And fade out.
Thank you.
So we're up on Hacksaw Ridge, and right here you can see there's a cave area. It's closed, obviously, but there are a ton of caves on Okinawa, and that's where a lot of the locals hid themselves and lived for that time to save themselves. And this cave is where I think a lot of the Japanese military hid during the fight on Hacksaw Ridge. And you can see people still leave offerings. And then when you go places, you'll see the origami cranes, which means peace. If you go to, there's certain caves around island and other places that you'll see a huge group of cranes joined together for that. So Ryan's going to give you a cliff note version of Hacksaw Ridge.
Hacksaw Ridge. Hopefully I get most of it right. So the Japanese would hide in a cave, like Erica said, back this direction right here. So it wasn't too far. And then this ridge right here was more, you can't really see it, the vegetation on it, but it was straight down. Obviously they won't let us get real close to the edge. And then our forces were down in this area and they climbed the wall. The movie depicts it quite well, except it shows the wall as being really, maybe a lot, possibly a lot taller than it was. Maybe not, maybe they tried to get it as close as they could to the original, but this is where Desmond Doss received his Congressional Medal of Honor for valor. He was a conscientious objector, if you want to call it that, to the war. He wanted to participate, but he didn't want to be armed. So he was a medic, and he figured out that, or he understood or felt that that was the best way he could represent the country without picking up a weapon. So he was up here, tended to the wounded, and the one time they kept coming up and back down because it, obviously the Japanese had the advantage of being on the high ground, but they came up, well, he got left for dead up here, but he wasn't. And so, and during the night, he lowered down, I believe, around 75 U.S. soldiers who were wounded, saved them, saved 75 of them, as far as my knowledge goes. But he also, that cave that Erica just showed you not too long ago, he got into that cave and he tended to the Japanese wounded as well. All the while, the Japanese were walking right past him, didn't know he was there. I believe he faked that he was dead. But then he himself got down off this, it's called the Maida Escarpment as well, as the Japanese refer to it. So as he got down here, that was his contribution. And he lowered all 75 down with a rope by himself. Nobody helped him off this cliff. And he wasn't a big guy. He was, wet, maybe 150. probably about 6 foot. He passed away, oh gosh, I think it was probably in 2009 or six through nine, somewhere in there. Just an amazing person. But he also fought on Iwo Jima as well. It may have been some other ones that he participated in as well as a medic. So it wasn't just here. He got the medal. This was kind of the icing on the cake for him for the medals. But he had these other battles that he participated in as well. So this is a sacred spot right here.
And if you haven't seen the movie Hacksaw Ridge, I highly recommend you watch it because it's powerful. It's
great, just, great Mel Gibson flick.
It is a really good show. And I'm not really into war flicks and things like that, but this one, yeah, if you haven't watched it, when people would come visit, we'd say, we're going to take you to Hacksaw Ridge. Make sure you watch the movie before you come, or we'll watch it together, just so you have a better understanding when we go to Hacksaw Ridge what took place there. So
also, right, you can't really see it, but in the shoreline right over here in this area and to the left is where the our ships came in, and a load of troops on this side. There were some on the other side as well, but this was the main advancement.
And over, let me see if I can zoom in. I'm looking at, I have my glasses on.
Over here,
there's Futenma.
Futenma Flatline. But to the left, there's a blue globe looking like.
Oh yeah, I see it right there.
And that's Kakazu Ridge, and our troops were on the other downside of that as well. And we'll go over there and speak about that in just a little while.
So we're just right across. We'll be going there after. So real quick, right here, this is a Marine base called Futenma.
You see the Osprey V-22s there on the right-hand side, parked, lined up.
Yeah, it's kind of, I have a hard time seeing where I'm at because of the brightness. It's like right there. You can see them. But we are like mid-island, and Futenma, like I said, is a military, marine base. So Ryan's going to tell you about the importance of Kakazu Ridge.
The importance of it. So from Futenma there, which is probably maybe a mile away, if that, to where, to the edge of the runway, to where we are is about a mile. So just below us in the trees, we'll go down there in a minute. But it's quite a steep incline, almost straight up as well. And from that point at the end of the runway to where we are right here took our military 2 weeks to get to this point, to get up here on the hill, because down below us in the trees are pillboxes that the Japanese military were entrenched in. And there was quite a few, a lot more than what there is now. And obviously quite a few people hidden. So they're in an elevated position, which gives them a complete advantage. But yeah, 2 weeks from that point to here, it took them to get that far.
Quite. And I'm a slow runner, but I think it wouldn't have taken me 2 weeks. Maybe 20 minutes.
It would have taken me 2 weeks and a day.
So yeah, that's Kakazu Ridge. We'll go down, and there's a couple pillboxes that we can actually get in. So we'll go down there. But this is the East China Sea over here, like I said.
Well, Kadena Air Base is off in the distance.
Yeah, it's over here.
It's over the hill there.
And then further south, a few miles, is Kinzer, which is another Marine base. We have...
Navy. Or is it Marine?
No, it's Marine. Okay. There's only one Navy base here.
White Beach.
Oh, actually two. Shields and White Beach.
Gotcha.
The rest are Marine and... Anyway, so this is Uraso.
Okinawans are very small, short. Obviously, they're easy. They can fit in here easily. One of the openings is right here. Off Terica's right is an opening, what it would look like without being damaged. Rebar throughout this thing. I believe it was probably deeper than what I'm in right now. But as you can see, back down that way is where our troops would have come from and advanced towards this box. And the Japanese had complete advantage, because past that rail, back behind Erica, it dropped straight down. So, and then again, if you were a sniper in here, you had a great field of view. Obviously, if the trees were gone.
I don't think the trees and stuff were there at the point in time after.
So yeah, 2 weeks from there to here. But there's a picture back up there in the description where they actually had a pretty good sized gun. Not sure what millimeter it was. The barrel's all frayed out. But yeah, they come in from behind me here. This little opening. And I think it was a lot deeper in here. And that hole was actually dug down quite a bit more. But that's it.
Cool. Thank
you. Peace.